Say the last time you came on our show, we had this giant idea for you.
Yeah.
Right? And we asked you because we wanted to do a bit and we thought of like different ideas. And actually, did you come up with this idea?
Well, my idea was much simpler. I thought maybe I would just be teaching. I thought it would be fun to do something from Footloose, but I thought maybe I'd be teaching you how to dance a la Let's Hear It for the Boy. I
didn't know that Denise Williams.
And then when I got the pitch from you guys, it was like Angry Warehouse Dance. And I thought, oh, no, I can't do the Angry Warehouse Dance. Yeah. It's just too much. And it was so elaborate, but your team was so great that I just kind of plugged right into it. I mean, everything was kind of done for me.
You were here all day shooting. Like it was yeah. a full day of shooting.
Well, the crazy thing was is I was working on the following, and I wrapped the night before at about, literally like 2 o'clock in the morning, and I'm standing in my kitchen, and I'm trying to remember some of these moves, and I'd seen the thing that you had put together, and I had to go and rent Footloose on Netflix, literally, because I didn't have the movie.
You don't own your own movies?
No.
Come on, you have to.
I'm standing there with the kitchen, in the thing, and the camera going. I'm like, I can't do it.
It was too much. You did it.
I was really overwhelmed.
It was unbelievable. Well, that's you in our studio.
Meanwhile, the thing is.
I mean, it was unbelievable.
But here's this is the thing, though, is that you know you work so hard in the course of your life, and you know you do work that you hope is going to affect people, you know, moving roles and complex, you know, dramas and all that stuff. And people come up to me in an airport right now, and they say, "I got to tell you, the most moving thing you've ever done, the thing that touched me most, was your appearance on Jimmy Fallon." Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, no, that's it. That's all you needed. Yeah. It was moving. It was great. I mean, and then you called us back because you were going to an 80s themed party.
I know. Well, what happened was there was a friend of mine was having an 80s themed party, and I said, okay, well, I can't really go to an 80s themed party and not be me.
I know, I really should have, actually.
But I thought to myself, I mean, I could be,
we
you
just
know, Judd
did it.
Nelson, or I could be
we just did a
Madonna,
couple weeks ago.
You know what I mean? And so I needed the jacket, and I was trying to think. I actually asked our costumer on the following, where could I get that red tuxedo jacket? And she said, well, why don't we just call up Fallon? You guys were nice enough to lend it to me.
And you tweeted it out, and there's the jacket. Yeah. And we were so happy you wore it again. It was so fun.
Yeah.
And did it go
a little crap on the sleeve there.
No problem. It's your jacket, man.
It was funny, though, because I walked into the party, and everyone's like really elaborate. You know, this is this theme party, and they're all done up to the nines. And some guy goes, dude, too easy.
Yeah, you can't do you from Footloose, man.
Yeah.
Come on, that's not
too
fair.
Too easy, yeah.
But that's what you do. You have to do that. I mean, it's like inviting John Cryer to an 80s party, and he's not going to be Ducky. You go, you got to be Ducky, man.
There were a lot of Duckies there, by the way.
That's a great costume, Ducky.
I don't think John himself was there, but there were definitely Duckies, wall-to-wall Duckies.
You didn't get any photos from the party, though.
No, I didn't actually.
No.
Yeah, this is a kind of a cool party because on the invitation it says, please don't take any photos or tweet anything.
Oh my God.
So you can imagine.
Oh, I guess so, yeah. It's one of those cool parties.
It's one of those cool parties.
I never get invited to those. No.